So for the last part of this short trip, Brendan and Miles took me to meet an old friend of theirs, a man by the name of Wang Da Peng. So Wang Da Peng is teaching Chinese language and culture at Australian National University, and he grew up in Anhui province in central China, which along with Henan is a huge center in China for Hui Muslim martial arts. So from a very young age, he learnt all of the typical Muslim styles like Cha Quan, Tan Tui, Xinyi Liuhe, Qi Shi Quan, as well as some other like local village Anhui styles that you won't really see outside of the region. Then later on, he moved to Shanghai, where he became a professional athlete at Shanghai University of Sports before finally migrating here to Australia. So Master Wang is what you would call in Chinese Wen Wu Shuang Quan, which means he's proficient in both martial pursuits and pursuits of literature. And because of that, his martial journey has taken him more down the route of like the sort of philosophical or cultivational side of martial arts. And so for this interview, Miles, Brendan and myself, we sat down with Master Wang to chat with him about his experiences growing up and training martial arts in China, a little bit about what some of the different styles he's trained are all about, as well as his own personal philosophies and thoughts on martial arts in general.
小时候是在河南，在河南住，然后对父母迁居到安徽，然后你在那里也学了拳，对，主要是在安徽学拳，跟我的姨父。
那你能不能讲你那个时候学拳的经历？我觉得因为那个是一个不同的时代，他们那时候
小孩子学拳，他们的性质都非常高，每天除了打拳。 就是打拳，哎，finish school，put the school bag on the ground, and first place will be your teacher's place. really expecting that you can learn something today, so you can practice. May have the intention to go outside, fight, and test it. But that's when you're younger. 小的时候都是这样。 反正不像现在孩子对他没有兴趣，我们那时候就我也不知道为什么兴趣这么高，因为没有什么其他东西可以做，没有这些 screen， 没有 internet， only have very basic toys， and of course the communication with your wushu brothers becomes more important and more fun， when you're young, you've got hormones around in your body, you just want to, show how powerful,
Some people stay like
more powerful, or me more powerful, so you compete with each other.
You know,
in your root, middle node, and the tips are well connected. 你踢弹腿，踢弹腿，啪！你出去以后，高踢，但是矮用。往高里面踢，但是往矮里面用，高踢矮用。弹腿非常好。弹腿非常好。其实我建议，如果有机会的话，其实每个人都应该把弹腿当做武术基本功，不管你是练八卦也好，练螳螂也好，就弹腿基本。但是呢，有时候你练的时间长了，你站着你不想起来。 You不是说you don't have the muscle endurance, you have too much endurance, you just want to keep going.
It's quite hard, it's hard work.
It is.
Proper tantui is hard.
Proper tantui is hard. 昆仑大仙世界传，弹腿技法傲无边。 It says the tantra was taught by what do you call it, immortals?
Like I do. Tantra技法傲无边，就说它非常奥妙。嗯，哎，哦，你不知道它有多rich。嗯，哎，世人莫看法事单，多习多练之根源，就你不要看，it's so easy, simple。嗯，哎，多习多练之根源，
and the more you practice, the better findings you will have.
嗯，简单，非常简单。他有时候两人可以一起练，弹腿可以两人一起练。
既有对练，
对练，对。嗯，现在会的人比较少。嗯，那你当时跟老师学拳是怎么样的情况？老师学拳嘛，我们的师兄弟非常多，几十个师兄弟在一起练习，大的带小的，反正大家都比着练。 以前练的时候，我记得都是脱掉衣服，光着膀子打，练那些
condition。嗯，
都是这样打。我们当时有练摔跤、茶拳、弹腿，哎，新义拳，这个东西。
哦，你小时候也是学新义拳？
小时候看，哎，那先从弹腿和茶拳入手，最后长大一点了，开始老师教新义拳。
这也是同一个老师。
同一个老师，对，因为。
新义拳在那个时候呢还是比较保守，因为老师要考察人品，先从基本的弹腿、插拳看你是不是这块料，
那他两个拳的之间也有关系吧？因为我一般的练新义拳的人是先从很多练对很多练新义拳的人，他们多少都接触到插拳，因为都是。 穆斯林兄弟传承下来的，他们还练七十拳，七十拳，七十拳，你也学了吗？我经历过，那好东西，那绝对是好东西，七十拳，汤平七十拳，对，
这个他们是最保守，他们比新义拳还保守，
汤平，那叫汤平湖中流妙拳，因为汤平是汤平湖。 哎，有个湖，你知道吗？嗯，你见到过那个穆斯林的餐厅里面，基本上都有个汤平湖，这个往那一拉，哎，拉这个汤平湖，这就是湖，the spot，这就是 它为什么是叫新义拳？因为它讲究新义拳，它有它的历史，应该说是我们这个古代的武术的圣人，说通过它的这个不叫练习，叫修炼，所总结出来的。 合乎天地运行法则的一种对上升的道的层次上的一种修为，不只是停留在这个技术层面上面上升，更重要的是你的这个心性的提升和文化的传承，这是非常重要的。说心意权。 外三合、内三合，the three internal harmonies and external harmonies. That's good stuff. But still, 停留在什么？停留在这种术的境界上面。还没有停留在法。 我到底如何运用数学的新一禅，新一六合拳，它呈现给我们的是一种立体的一种空间的一种东西。为什么这样说呢？因为它和这个五行八卦有甚深的渊源。这个拳，所以说我老师就说，大鹏不要认为这只是一个拳，don't just regard it as a martial art。就是道。所以我老师跟我讲，这是道。
This is Zhang Lao Sheng, yeah, and he was Muslim, right?
He's not Muslim, but Lu Lao Sheng accepted him as his disciple.
So he's not Hui.
Yeah, he's not Hui, but he's 他是一个很有学问的人.
But he's teaching using Dao methodology. I mean, like it's not which is something unique for Xinyi Liuhe, right?
Yeah.
It's not a standard approach for that. Yeah.
He got a high level of literacy.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
他是在安徽？他不是，他住在上海，
他是从辽宁，从辽宁那边，然后。